did with your book this week. So when you introduce yourself, tell how you feel, and then what you did for your book this week.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Go to the front, baby. You, well, look, while you're up there, when you finish, you might as well do a poem. Stop playing. You can come forward a little bit towards the audience. You ain't got to stand all the way back. No doubt, baby. There you go.
So, let me first just...
That's right. Give him away, baby.
So, hey, everybody.
Hello, how you doing?
Hey.
Hello.
I'm working on... Everybody hear me? Great. I'm working with my book, Legenda and the Golden Heart. It's a fiction book, or I call it Reading for Ages. So I created kind of like my own history of what if this young man who goes on this quest actually believes that he loves his family and the way that his community helped him and loved him were actually the forerunner hundreds of years ago to the Kwanzaa that we celebrate now, that Dr. Malana Karenga created in the 1960s. So that's kind of like the backstory to it. And so I just did 400 paperbacks last year. It sold out. And so now the goal was to bring out the hardcover for this fall. And I should be, thank you.
Yes.
Finishing up doing some final corrections and changes, and the hardcover should be going into Ingram Spark next week. So, cross your fingers. Hopefully, this will do very well. One of the things that I'm doing is that next week I'm sending out an email to just about everybody I know on the planet, asking them, not asking them to buy the book, asking them to recommend people to me, Nora, that would be interested in buying bundles of the book, buying it in bulk, to donate to schools or libraries or churches, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm also working on a pitch letter to educational. So it's interesting what you were saying, Asada, because I'm working on a letter that hopefully... I'm going to send out to the education departments,
beautiful,
colleges and universities, trying to encourage the instructors to pick up this book as a book that they use in their class, which of course would mean that that their students would have to buy it.
Absolutely.
Those are the kinds of things that that I've been working
on. Yes. Oh, I love it, I love it, I love it. And aren't you going to be at the event tomorrow?
Am I what?
Aren't you going to be at that event tomorrow?
Yes. Tomorrow, for anyone, if there's anybody here who has the children's book, or anybody here who has a family with young kids or grandkids or whatever, tomorrow, First in the Books, a fabulous organization, is doing their first Words of Wonder Literary Festival. And it's going to have everything.
Nice.
It's going to have storytelling. I'll be reading my story. And they're also going to have community resources and vision and hearing and vaccinations and all kinds of stuff. There'll be vendors there. There'll be games and math writing classes for kids from itty-bitties up through adult. And there'll also be an art and illustration class for kids and teens. And also Jacqueline Woodson should be awesome.
Excellent. Weren't y'all on a morning show or something like that?
Oh, Pitch Woman. Thank you. You were really... Yes. We were on Daytime Chicago on Monday pitching the festival. And I got a chance to pitch my book, too.
You sure did, baby. You had it up on the table. Let them know, baby.
Yes, they did.
Nice. Excellent, excellent. All right, so we got, you know, me and Jerima, somebody was calling me book goddess, and then I gave that title right on over to Jerima. I said, book goddesses, let's go, boop, 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 and continue to organize, you know what I mean? So, as I mentioned earlier, we did a children's book fair together. She was the dean of a school. And so we did it at the school, so I'm just loving to see the emergence and the, you know, expanding of what we're going to do literary-wise. I think, you know, Chicago is a big city for the arts, like, you know, painting and, you know, art galleries and dancing. But we have to make the writing a thing, you know what I mean? And you talk about, you know, Nora's not saying a word, but... To me, you know, the excellence and the literary excellence obviously runs in your family. You know what I mean? And you can tell from your style, from your the way you handle topics and the way you address our people. She is the daughter of Gwendolyn Brooks, guys. And so what? That is just no small thing. But I want to revive that literary excellence that, you know, your mom and Lorraine Hansberry and all of them, you know, had. I want to revive that. So, we on the move.
Yes.
Thank you, baby. Thank you so much.
Thank you for
asking. No doubt. Excellent. And so, here we go. You came right on time. So, Taquan, come on up here and introduce yourself.